Hello. So now we're going to do this example, okay? Okay, let's read it together. A taxicab charges $3 to pick you up and 25 cents per mile. If you were charged a total of $7.50, for how many miles were you in the taxi? Okay, so the first thing that I can do is I can say, okay, if I didn't know algebra, what I could do is I could say, okay, $3 when they pick me up. And I could say, okay, I'm going to add 25 cents. Okay. So I get 325. So after 1 mile, I'm at 325. Okay, I can add 25 cents again. I can add this. And I can get 5 plus 5 is 10. I bring down the 0, carry the 1. 1 plus 2 is 3, 4, 5. And then I bring down the 3. Right? After 2 miles, I'm at 350. And I can keep on going like this. And you can see that I'll probably be here all day calculating until I get to 350. I mean, until I get to 750, right? Until I get to 750. But so, there has to be a better way. And that's the advantage of algebra. So now, let's do this problem algebraically together, okay? I'm gonna label what my variable is gonna be. We're gonna let X represent the miles in the taxi. Okay, let X be the miles in the taxi. Then, we remember that multiplication, for example, can be seen as repeated addition. So, we know that 0.25 times 1 would be 0.25. 0.25 times 2 would be 0.25 times 0.25. 0.25 times 3 would be 0.25 plus 0.25 plus 0.25. And in general, if we have 0.25 times x, that'll be 0.25 added for as many miles as we go. Okay? So in other words, what I'm saying is that 0.25x, this is going to represent the cost of riding x miles in the taxi. Right? Okay. The next thing they tell us, of course, or the first thing they told us, is that we need to pay $3 when we just get in the taxi, right? That's the pickup fee or whatever it's called. And so, in order to take care of that, we're going to write this as 3 plus 0. Well, we can write it like this. Let me write it in a different way. 0.25x plus 3. Okay. And so this then will be our taxi rate cost. For x miles. So here, this will represent the cost of riding the taxi for X miles, okay? And by the way, if it seems like I'm going very delicately through this problem, it's because I want to go through all the steps of forming this equation, all the thought process of forming this equation. And if this kind of equation is too simple, you know, don't worry, they're not all gonna be this simple. But I also wanna make sure that I get everyone capable of understanding how to do these kind of like setups and how I go from one variable to another part of the problem until I get to where I need to be. In this case, this form is where I need to be for our problem, okay? So now we can finally approach the end of this problem because we can say, okay, aha, they tell us that the total cost of this trip has been $7.50. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set my cost of my trip equal to the cost of riding the taxi for X miles, and then I'm going to solve for X, And that's going to permit us then to answer the question, the original question. Okay, so let's do that together. So the cost of riding the taxi is 0.25x plus 3. And we know that we spent $7.50. And we want to know how many miles we drove. So if I solve this equation, it'll tell me how many miles I drove. So I have, so to solve this equation, I want to isolate my x. So I'm going to go minus 3, minus 3. Okay, let me line that up properly here. Okay. Okay. And then, for example, now here I can do the subtraction, okay? 0 minus 0 is 0, 5 minus 0 is 5. I bring down my decimal place, 7 minus 3 is 4, and then I bring my equal sign. This goes away, and I'm left with 0.25x equals to 4.5. Now, if you think about it, so in other words, okay, so then from here, I'm going to divide both sides by 0.25. Okay. Now, so that gives us x equals to 4.50 divided by 0.25. Okay, if I think of that in terms of quarters, I know I need 4 quarters for a dollar. I have $4 here, so I'll have 16 quarters, and then the 15 cents, 17, 18 total quarters, or in other words, x equals 18. But of course, what I want to do here, very briefly, is I want to do that for you with long division to show you again. So here, if I want to do 4.50 divided by 0.25, what I'm going to do first is I'm going to multiply the top and bottom by 100 so that I have no decimal places, okay? So 450 over 25. So then that is equivalent to this division problem. 25 goes into 450, okay? Now, one of the things I recommend to all my clients when I'm going to do a division like this is to have a multiplication of 25 nearby. And here we go. I have a multiplication of 25 nearby. And the reason why I do this is that I see a lot of students, when they're faced with a division problem, they'll start going back and forth between multiplying to see how many times a number goes to another number and back and forth. If you make your multiplication table first, then you don't have to be doing that. Now, by the way, strictly speaking, I could have made this multiplication table by multiplying, but all you have to do is, like, for obviously n equals 1, 1 times 25 is 25, and then you can just add 25 to 25 to get 50, add 25 to get 75, add 25 to get 100, etc. And also, we only need the digits 1 to 9, because when you're performing the division, you cannot put 2 digits at a time here. You just go 1 at a time, okay? Okay, let's proceed now. So I asked myself, does 25 go into 45? And in fact, of course, we know it goes one time only. 1 times 25 is 25. Then I subtract 5 minus 5 is 0. 4 minus 2 is 2. And then I bring down this 0. That will be 8. Aha. And of course, 8 times 25 is 200. And we can see that that's remainder 0. Okay. So we see that x equals 18. Okay. So what does this tell us? This tells us that we rode in the taxi for 18 miles. Okay. Now, before we say goodbye to this problem, I want to foreshadow a discussion that we're going to have later, okay? And so, strictly speaking, as far as this problem is concerned, you don't have to watch the rest for now, but if you'd like to, I'm going to foreshadow something that we're going to talk about later, and it's not that important, but it's kind of important, and I want to tell you about it now, okay, of course? Mostly, it's just a matter of notation, but you'll see that this will become more important over time. So, for example, here we've agreed that this expression, 0.25x plus 3, represents the cost of the taxi ride as per the description given in our problem, right? So one of the things we're going to talk about later on in this in our algebra discussions is functions, okay? So what I can do here is I can say, okay, I can make a cost function, okay? And what I can say is that, for example, let me write down this notation first, and then I'll explain what I mean. Okay? So here, I'm going to say that C is my cost function, and it takes an input, the number of miles that you're in the taxi. And what does it output? It outputs how much you spent to ride the taxi for that many miles. Okay, so this is notation we're going to see later. And in other words, yes. And so I wanted to preface, like, because we're going to see functions later, and I want to preface with the simple problem how an expression like this that represents some value in terms of another can be formalized as a function. So here the cost of going X miles will be equal to this expression with X miles plugged in. And of course, there could be functions for so many different things. The height of an object in flight, in this case the cost, and it all depends on what kind of field you want to use the algebra for. Okay. So and in fact, I'm gonna go a little bit further along these lines, just for fun here. Okay, let me see. Should I get rid of this? No. Oh yeah. So. I know that as far as this problem is concerned, we already finished it. You don't, like, the rest of this is going to be a little bit more extra stuff, but I can't help it. So later on, we're also going to talk about lines, okay? So you'll notice that this is a linear function, okay? And how do I know that it's a linear function? Because I can see that it can be written as y equals to mx plus b. You see, this is my m, my 0.25, and my b is my 3. And this represents a linear function in slope-intercept form, okay? By the way, what I'm saying, if you don't understand this part, you're going to understand it later as we start talking about the topics in more depth, but I wanted to illustrate this here to, again, to foreshadow what's going to come ahead. Now, here, the m is our slope, and our y-intercept is 3. So now I'm actually going to graph this cost function. Again, this is not part of this problem, strictly speaking, so you don't have to, like, follow along here. But, like, later, when you watch this problem solution again, you'll be able to appreciate this more. So right now I'm gonna graph this line. Again, you don't have to follow along here if you're just watching this for the first time. But if you're watching these, you know, as you move forward, like, and you understand this, you will understand this at a certain point in the future if you continue watching my videos. And so I want this to be here, so, you know, to give a complete picture. Okay, so now here I have a graph paper that I've drawn special for this problem. I know that my y-intercept is the b, okay? So I know it'll cross the y-axis at 3. So I can put a little dot there, okay? And so down here, this axis represents the miles ridden. I don't think that this is how you spell that. I don't even know if that's a word. So, miles ridden. We'll just leave it. Okay, we'll just accept that this may or may not be a word, but we'll know what it means. How many miles you rode. Okay, miles rode. Yeah. Miles rode in taxi. And then the height here will represent the cost of the taxi rental. And then, so now, we already put our y-intercept. Now, we know that this slope represents our rise over run. So since in this case it's 0.25, our interpretation is that to go from a point on the line, for example, to go from my y-intercept 3 to another point in the line, I'm gonna go 0.25 up for every unit to the right. And if you know that 0.25 is 1/4, then if I go one up, I can go 4 to the right, okay? Right, because 0.25 is equal to 1/4, so therefore I can go up 1 and 4 to the right. So let me do it like that. Here, if I go 1 up and then 4 to the right, I'll put a point here. Let me see. And then if I go 1 up again and I go 4 to the right, I'll go here. Okay. And one of the things I want you to notice is that here, whereas my vertical axis has been is measured in ones, 1, 2, 3, etc., my miles axis is in fours, and I did that intentionally because I knew that I wanted to be able to fit more data here, because I had seen that I had to go 18 miles to reach 7.50 in cost. You see? And so let me see here. I'm going to go up 1 again and then 4 to the right. So let me see here. And then something like that. Damn. Okay. And you can see that right here, if I draw a horizontal line from 7.5 and I drop that vertical down to the axis, it arrives right here at 18. So we see that point 18, 7.5, which represents the solution to our original problem, is here on the graph of this line. Okay, and in general, this line represents how much it costs. So if I went 4 miles in the taxi, I would have paid $4. If I went 8 miles in the taxi, I would have paid $5. And if I had went somewhere like here, like let's say for 6, then I would have gone 4.5. Okay? And of course, I can use the cost function to demonstrate this. Oh my God, I can't believe I'm going this way off on a tangent, but I just want to show this to you. And I'm just going to do 2 calculations with this cost function, interpreting it as a cost function. And so you guys can get used to the function notation also. And let's do that. So for example, let's say I have the cost of a 3 mile trip. Okay, I'm gonna calculate the cost of a 3 mile trip. Well, what does this mean? This means that for the function named C, I'm gonna input 3 and I'm gonna output this expression evaluated at 3. So it'll be 0.25 times 3 plus 3. Now, if you think of this in terms of quarters, 0.25 times 3 would be 0.75. And then I add 3 like this. And then finally, when I do that, I'm going to get 3.75. And so that would be the cost. So what does this say? They say that for a trip of 3 miles, the cost of taking that trip would be 3.75. Before I go off way off on another tangent, I'm going to stop right here. I hope you guys have enjoyed this explanation, and I look forward to seeing you again. Thank you.